Namaskaram Bhagavad Gita chapter 6 sloka 29. In this sloka Bhagavan says, one who is established in yoga, one with equanimous vision everywhere, sees his self in all beings and all beings in his own self. He explained the process of meditation and what should be the meditator's approach, how we should sit, that preparation of seat, and how to follow the process, and what is the vision of the perfect meditator. So he explained everything in the previous slokas. Now in this sloka, from this for three more slokas, he explains four types of yogi. So when we say yogi, yogi is not attached to material world. So he is without any attachment. So the one who established in yoga, he has the quality of looking at everything, every creation, every creature equally. So that is what meant by equanimity vision. So he sees himself in all the creatures and he considers all beings are in his own self. It is like the waves in the ocean. So we give the fictional names to the ocean, big wave, short wave, the long, that wave which is traveling for long distance and which is short wave. So all these names are given to the waves, but all these waves are in ocean only. This is the stage of yogi. The yogi sees himself in all beings. So the ocean is in all these forms, in short waves, long waves, big waves, small waves. The second one is, waves cannot exist without ocean. Third, ocean is water. So when we say I am wave, that's in water form. Other waves in water form. Ocean, that is also in water form. So yogi sees all beings in his own self. So these are the three qualities of yogi. So Bhagavan talks about this yogi in this sloka. So he has the sarvatra samana darshanaha. So he looks at everything equally. This kind of vision is not through our physical eyes. This is out of wisdom. And this is referred to third eye. So this yogi at this stage is Chitta Prajna. Bhagavan explains about Chitta Prajna in earlier chapters. So he sees everyone as Atma. Whether it is animal, bird or plant or a human being, he considers all Atmas are equal. So his attachment towards anything is not there. But he gives equal value to everything. So far Bhagavan taught us how to prepare our mind. So yogi has prepared his mind so well through meditation, and he focuses his mind only on Atma and has this equanimity. And he sees the qualities of Atma, not the physical qualities of the creatures. For example, human beings, whether he is dark complexion or he is fair or he is stout or he is thin or he is short, he is tall. He doesn't go by all that because he is not attached to body at all. So he doesn't consider them for any reference or anything, because as far as a yogi is concerned, he doesn't give importance to body. How does he look at people? By the vision of Atma. So Atma has qualities of jnanam, knowledge, then anandam, happiness, arivu, again intellect, then it serves. That is, Atma has the knowledge. Atma feels happy when it feels that it is with, or it is enslaving, or it is, it considers, Atma considers that he is serving God as a slave. So here, if Atma has a quality of attaching itself to Bhagavan, that is what the slave refers here. So slave refers to the attachment of Atma towards Paramatma. And Atma feels happy about it. Atma is happy because it is in union with Paramatma. And Atma knows that Paramatma lives within it. So, yogi looks at all Atmas only by these qualities. Whether he looks at animal, or whether he looks at a bird or a plant or a human being, he sees every one as Atma only. Every Atma with the same qualities. So there is no distinction, there is no differentiation, there is nothing is considered superior, nothing is considered inferior. So, Yoga Yukta Atma, and he sees that everything has got that, all Atmas have got that knowledge, and the Atma thinks that he is also made up of Jnana, that is, he has that knowledge, and he feels other Atmas also have knowledge. So yogi feels it. Yogi feels the Atma has got the knowledge. Then a yogi looks at other Atmas also with the same kind of knowledge. So he is able to look at everyone equally. So this is the quality of yogi. So and yogi sees himself in all beings, and he sees all beings in himself. So yogi, because God is pervading in everything. God is everywhere. So that Atma has got the quality of Paramatma. So when we even feel that Bhagavan is everywhere, so naturally Atma also feels that Bhagavan is everywhere, and it gives the due respect to every being. That is what the Atma does. So Atma has these qualities, and yogi understand this, and he views, his vision is I am Atma. So he has got that power through wisdom, that vision through wisdom. So yogi lives with this quality. So this is what explained in this sloka by Bhagavan. There was an incident about Jadabharata, who had this kind of attitude. That is, he lived as a yogi. Let's see that.